right, here we are. This is Absolute Radio. We're backstage. It's day one of Hard Rock Calling. My name is Ben, but this band want Geoff here. And there's nothing we can do about that. James, good to see you.
Well, can we call you Geoff?
You can call me Geoff. I don't have the ginger hair or the ginger beard or the...
You're lacking in Geoff attributes, really, aren't you?
I could be the Geoff tribute act, yeah. But anyway, I'm afraid you've got me, but it's nice to see you. Here we are. We're doing... I mean, I've interviewed you... many festivals over the years, and here we are, we're doing Hard Rock Calling.
We do like you too, Ben.
Am I sort of the backup Geoff?
No.
If Geoff's not on holiday, you're okay for me to do it?
No, you have your own characteristics and idiosyncrasies, just as Geoff does.
It's nice to have you back here, and I think you... have you played this festival before?
No.
Have you ever played Hyde Park before?
No.
We haven't.
Wow. We're looking around, though, just to check that one of us goes, yes, we have, because memory being such that you don't trust it.
I mean, by now, you've pretty much done all the festivals, all the sort of the great venues up and down the UK. Are there places that you've yet to play which you kind of think, well, maybe we should go there on the next tour?
We haven't played Glastonbury for a long time, and there's something always amazing about Glastonbury. That's the only one I'm kind of...
the ones in America, Coachella and...
Coachella,
Bonnaroo,
which they're looking at for next year.
Yeah. Well, have you done the Eden Project? I'd quite like to do the Eden Project.
Oh, I hear about this. This sounds...
that
good.
Just kind of looks, yes, like it should be in a Bond... well, it has been in a Bond movie, so it looks looks kind
of
cool to me.
The best of them all is the Burning Man Festival, but they don't take bands. But that would be the best of them all, to turn up acoustically and just play.
Does it ever feel like a normal 9-to-5 job when you do what it is that you do for a living?
No, we never.
9 to 5.
Nine till...
10:30.
The hours aren't bad, are they, being in a band?
No, they're not.
It doesn't ever feel like a normal office job doing what it is that you guys do.
You can get bogged down in 60 emails a day, you know, logistics. There's the amazing amount to be agreed on, from fine details of typefaces for posters to, you know, who do we credit on the record, which gets incredibly irritating. So there are aspects of the job that are, you know, not romantic as one would think. And the touring aspect, you know, the traveling's a pain in the bum. The playing is fantastic.
How do you make touring and life on the road a little bit more easier to deal with?
Sex, drugs.
And that's just between the three of you.
That's just between the three of us. Naked poker. Always goes down well on the band.
I think the painful thing about the job for me is there's a lot of hanging around. I mean, I think our drummer Dave says that the 30 years of being in James, it's 5 years playing and 25 years hanging around. And yeah. I think that's probably about right, to be honest with you. It's a lot of the time where you feel like you kind of wish you could do something that was constructive and positive, but you're just kind of waiting for stuff.
And what's your take on a festival like this, where, you know, the fans out there today have come to see a variety of different artists, some of whom are going to be James fans, some of whom will know the obvious big chart success songs. Is it difficult then to choose the set that you're going to play?
We've had 60 emails. Yep. Sent amongst the band on this issue.
Just
very
this
divided band at the moment.
From Tuesday.
Very hot. Emails, very passionate ones.
So someone's saying, play the hits, and someone's saying, well, actually, I want to play what I think the band should be playing right
yeah.
now.
Yeah.
And who's won?
Nobody
yet.
does the argument actually happen on stage?
Yeah, it will happen up until we go on stage.
So, I mean, do you feel obliged then that you have to play the obvious songs to a festival crowd?
No, not me, personally.
No, not obliged. I mean, it's a matter of getting that balance right, I think, where... obviously, you can pull a crowd in and you can make it work for them, but it also works for us as well. I mean, you know, we're there at every James gig, and therefore we have to make it fresh and alive and interesting for us. Otherwise, you know, obviously we wouldn't have been here for as long as we have. So, but it's finding that happy balance, I think, to be honest with you.
Do you stick around for the rest of the day? Are you keen to see who else is on? I mean, Kaiser Chiefs and The Killers tonight, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a good night, so we probably will, yes. Especially The Killers.
Yeah, Little Bird tells me that The Killers are fans of you and vice versa. Is that right?
Yeah, they've been really great with us. I mean, they invited us to play a gig in Poland and, you know, they're great. Great band.
Yeah, we did Lollapalooza with them in South America, in Chile. That was good.
When you do what you do for a living, when you're in a band and you're there playing your own songs night in, night out, do you go to a lot of gigs when you're not being part of the band?
I go to a few, but not necessarily because I want to, more as a social event or something like that, or I take my kids to gigs and things like that because I can get them in for free. You know, so, I mean, it's just, it's more opportunistic rather than going out of my way. If somebody like, if Grinderman was were playing in Manchester and I was in Manchester at the time, then I'd probably go out of my way.
Yeah.
You know, but that happens very rarely.
I'm very picky, look, and on the always on the lookout for somebody to inspire you, and so I'll only go to the gigs that I'm fairly sure I'm going to love.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you know, your musician head kicks in and starts pulling it apart. But Regina Spektor, Edward Sharpe, the Magnetic Zeros have blown me away in the last couple of years. So there are great, I find great music out there at the moment.
Have you been to see a great band or artist recently?
No, again, it's kind of a bit of a busman's holiday. I'm more than happy to have a break in between. When we're not working, I went to a lot more concerts. I've got a real kind of hunger and a passion to kind of have that blast of volume and noise and all the rest of it. But when we're busy, I don't have a great longing, to be honest with you. And again, unless it's somebody really special, I just stay at home.
Listen, give them a round of applause. Great to see them. It's James, everybody. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.